And now for something completely practical. The Diffie-Hellman key exchange. You have already met our elliptic curve, so now it's time to meet our two friends, Elise and Bob. Hi, Elise.
Hi.
Hi, Bob.
Hello.
These guys want to communicate securely. This requires them to establish a shared secret. A shared secret to be used as an encryption key. To do it, they agreed to use the elliptic curve we have designed throughout this series and to start with a point 4-5 as the generator. Each of them is using their own torus for performing the calculations. First, Elise rolls dice to randomly choose a secret number to be her private key.
I rolled 3.
Now she multiplies the generator by her secret number and thus creates her public key.
First, I double the point G to get the point 2G, and then I add the point G again to get my public point A, which equals to 3G. My public point A lies at 1322.
And now Bob creates his private key.
I rolled 7.
To complete this phase, Bob computes his public key as well.
First, I double the point G to get the point 2G, then I double it again to get the point 4G. Now I sum the points 4G and 2G to get the point 6G, to which I add the generator again, and my public point B, which equals to 7G, is computed. My public point B has coordinates 17, 8.
With their public points available, Elise and Bob exchange them. As you can see, Elise doesn't know that B equals to 7G, and Bob doesn't know that A equals to 3G. To continue with the key exchange, Elise multiplies the point B by her secret number.
First, I double the point B to get the point 2B, and then I sum it with the point B again. This way, I got the point K with coordinates 15, 5.
Now Bob does the same.
I perform the same steps as before, but I start with the point A. By doubling it, I get the point 2A. That one, I double again, and the point 4A is here. Summing the points 4A and 2A, I end up with the point 6A, to which I add the point A again. Now that I'm finished, I got the point K with coordinates 15, 5.
As you can see, Elise and Bob ended up with exactly the same point K, while during the exchange, only the points A and B could be seen by someone else watching their communication. Thus, Elise and Bob now have their shared secret and can use it for encrypting their messages. Thank you, Elise, and thank you, Bob.
You're welcome.
No problem.
Thank you for watching. And please, subscribe to our YouTube channel and remember to follow us on Twitter.